Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Biology Reader. Today in this session, I am going to explain the term anther, its morphological characteristics, anatomical features, and some of the important events related to it. So friends, let's get started. Friends, let us start the video by defining the term anther. In simple words, an anther contributes to the flower's male reproductive part, because it exists as a sac-like structure that reserves the pollen grains, or we can say male gametes. The bilobed pollen sac or anther and this long and slender filament together form a male reproductive part of the flower that is commonly called stamen, or sometimes it is also called as endrysium. Friends, we must have seen the anther of the flower, but do you remember how it actually looks like? Well, it's easy to remember the morphological characteristics of the anther. All you need to do is just have a look into this picture. Here you could see a knob-like structure, which is nothing but the anther. Then you could also see that there are two lobes or chambers, and majority of the flowers have a bilobed anther. Then the question is how these two lobes are connected. So friends, the answer is parenchymatous connective tissue that connect these two lobes. Last but not the least, anther is attached with a long and slender filament. We have discussed the external features of an anther, but now it's time to study the intrinsic features of an anther. Friends, if you will cut the anther transversely, you would find this kind of a view. Here in this diagram, you could see two thecae, each in a first lobe and a second lobe, due to which anther is sometimes called as tetrathecus or tetramicrosporangiate. Theca or microsporangia merely refers to the smaller units within the anther that stores the male gametes or the pollen grains. Friends, number of theca may vary in different flowers. Then stomium is the region of pollen dehiscence that separate these four chambers. Friends, now let us discuss the anatomy of an anther. This is the transverse section of an anther, and here you could see the distinct layer of cells within the anther. First and the outermost layer is of epidermis, which exist as a monolayer of flat cells. Then the second layer is an outer endothecium, in which the cells exist as a single layer and have a compact arrangement. Then the middle or intermediate layer usually comprises 1 to 3 layers of loosely arranged parenchymatous cells. The last layer is the inner tapetum, in which the cells appear pyramid-shaped, and it is closest to the sporogenous cells and serves as a nutritive layer by providing nourishment to the developing sporogenous cells. Let us end up the slide by discussing some of the important events that are associated with the anther. First one is anthesis. It is the stage during which the bud converts into a mature flower by exposing its male anther and female stigma. Then dehiscence is the stage during which the pollen grains are released out of the pollen sac via stomium, and it generally occurs once the cells of the anther become dry or fibrous. There are different ways of pollen dehiscence. Pollens can be released out transversely, longitudinally, from the apical or distal ends, and through some valves. Then pollination is an important event in which the pollen grains released from the male anther and reach the platform of the female stigma via insect or wind pollination in order to fertilize the ovules that are present within the flower's ovary. So friends, this is all for today, and to study this topic in detail, you may visit our official website, that is biologyreader.com. Link is provided in the description box. So friends, if you find this lesson helpful, do like, comment, share, subscribe my channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon and stay tuned for more videos.